I don't care where you want to move to, there are going to be rules governing what you can and can't do on your property. I'm quite certain that even if you owned a cabin in the middle of the Mojave Desert, 20 miles from the nearest neighbor, there are rules governing what you can and can't do. I'm guessing that some of these rules start with international treaties, perhaps even extraterrestrial treaties. One of my favorite movies is the original, The Day the Earth Stood Still. But unless you dabble with nuclear materials, they probably don't apply to you. What could apply to you are more common, seemingly mundane rules, at least mundane until they affect your use of your home. All of the following are potentially at issue. Whether you can build an outbuilding, whether you can install a swimming pool, either above ground or in ground, whether you can install fences, whether you can park your RVs or boats on your property, whether you can park commercial vehicles in your driveway. In other words, if you're a plumber and drive your company truck home from work. Whether you can install a screened-in porch. Whether you can install a satellite dish. Where you can install a satellite dish or solar panel. What color you can paint your house, even your front door or trim. How you can barbecue on your balcony. Where overnight guests can park their car. The age of residents. Whether you can have an outside clothesline, whether you can run a business from your home, whether you can rent your unit to a tenant, or even whether you can install a basketball hoop in the driveway. Now you might chuckle to yourself, but I can guarantee that each of these issues has come up with a homeowner someplace. As you are thinking of purchasing something, particularly in a more restrictive condo or townhome subdivision, or a more affluent community, these issues will come up, and before you buy, you'll want to ask yourself whether you'll ever need to address any of these items. So bottom line, if you're moving into a senior community, you'll have to ask yourself, is there any chance that your child or grandchild will ever have to move in with you? Now your list of concerns might be different, but the answers are available, you just have to ask. Start with your realtor or attorney.